How are you doing this week?
Better.
It's been a long couple months.
Yeah. Yeah, the nightmares aren't as vivid.
You know, I've discovered that while wounds heal over time, often scars do remain. Jennifer, I want you to close your eyes and picture his face. How do you feel?
I know I need to forgive him, but honestly, I hate him.
Yeah. Well, you feel hate towards this man, and rightly so. But I'm telling you, forgiveness is the only way to break free.
We're gonna get past this.
You will, you will. I wanna play a song for you, is that okay?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning.
Good morning. What time is it?
Almost 7. Even better.
What?
We're both awake. And the kids are sleeping.
What are you trying to get at?
You know. We both are awake. And the kids are sleeping soundly.
Yeah, okay.
You are so incredibly beautiful.
I have to pee.
Oh my god!
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
You are the queen of mood killers.
I know. Just like to see how badly you really want me.
You know how much. Just pretend we're still sleeping and they'll go away. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I packed my bag.
Yeah. You packed all by yourself?
Yeah, I want to see what I packed.
Yeah. Toys. Maddie, where are your clothes?
But I need all of these. This and this and everything else in here.
Sweetie, let's go repack your bag. You're gonna need some clothes for our camping trip, okay?
Yeah, it's Dad's gonna help you repack.
Fine, whatever.
Okay. We're gonna go brush my hair and then we get dry. Okay.
Ready, sweetie?
Camping trip. Get up. Come on, get up.
Mom, stop.
It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up.
Okay.
Okay. Johnny! Don't forget to pack more than one pair of underwear this time, okay?
Of course, Mom.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, baby, let me help you. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good, good. What's the disposition on the reports? Perfect. All right, are we all in the clear? Good, great. Hey, the last thing we need is for this to come back at us again.
Babe, you're about to go on vacation. Can you, like, wrap this up?
All right, just make sure everything is checked and cleared, and we'll press forward with the new reports. Uh-huh. All right, look, I'm officially on vacation. I look forward to your updates once I get back. Okay, thanks. Bye. Sorry. Last minute work stuff I had to get done. I'm officially all yours.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. You have all of me right now.
Well, since I have your undivided attention,
mm-hmm.
You can help me finish loading up the car.
All right, sure.
Okay.
Need your help.
about that.
It's stuffy tough.
There. There we go.
There we go.
Did you step on a bug or something?
I don't want to die.
What? What do you mean?
Johnny says there's bears in the forest and I eat little girls.
Oh, honey, no. Johnny was just telling you one of his crazy stories. You're not going to be eaten by bears. Johnny, however, will get a tuck from me real soon.
So there are no bears in the forest?
Well, there are some, but don't worry, Maddie. These bears are probably more afraid of us than we are of them, and I'm not going to let anything happen to you. I'm your mom. And I'm here to keep you safe. Besides, camping's all about having fun, and we're all gonna be fine. I promise.
I'm ready to protect Princess Maddie.
Johnny, what are you wearing?
Stand hut! Where's your canisters and MREs, Private?
Huh?
Yeah, I'm okay with them wearing this.
Please, Mom, real soldiers only need one outfit.
Sure, that's fine. I'm still gonna check to see what else you've packed.
You have to have real clothes in your suitcase, too, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Comrade, follow hut!
Essential gear. You know, one time we maintained a constant state of readiness over 48 hours.
Guarding our packs. You know, we couldn't sleep. You know, we
camping is great, honey. You know, we get to set up a tent, cook over a fire. We get to explore and see the animals and the big tall trees.
It's like living in the wilderness, honey.
I don't need mana.
Where did you get mana from?
What does mana taste like? I bet it tastes like chocolate cake.
Nice cake and cookies.
I bet it tastes like pancakes in the morning with maple syrup. But not burnt ones like Dad's.
What? Do you guys know what mana really tastes like?
What?
It's kind of like a thin cake with a sweet honey flavor.
So Johnny, your first guess was actually pretty close. And it does taste like cake.
Yeah, but except there's just no chocolate frosting.
No frosting!
Aww. It's the best part.
I know, but we have plenty of other good food that we've packed, so.
Like what?
Like peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and stuff to make s'mores,
food,
and grapes, and bananas.
I remember when we were in the kitchen, we talked about the s'mores.
Yeah.
Are you excited to make s'mores? They're my favorite.
They'll be really yummy.
Ready?
got it?
Awesome, awesome.
And the objective has been accomplished.
Johnny, why don't you help me set up the tent?
Hi.
Alright. Fine, thank you. Crazy things happen. I'm supposed to hammer this in.
What you got there? What is that?
Oh. Oh, hi.
Hi.
Beautiful day.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hi, I'm Tom.
I'm Jen.
If you're new for this area, there's a beautiful lake and beach that way. Just follow the path right there.
Thanks. We'll have to check it out. My husband's just over there.
Oh.
They'll tell.
Oh, I gotta go. Goodbye.
Bye.
Hey, who was that?
Oh, his name's Tom. I think he's a local, maybe. Anyways, he was telling us about a beach that we shall go to. I really want to go. What do you think?
Well, what's the weather like tomorrow? I heard there might be a cold front.
I mean, I'm sure the kids will still play in the sand. We should go. We missed it last year.
Sure. What time were you thinking? Tomorrow morning?
Yeah, maybe.
All right, perfect. Now, look, I know I told you I wouldn't work while on vacation, but John texted from the office and had a situation come up recently.
Why?
They're having problems with one of the accounts, and they would like me to go on this conference call to get the situation handled by tomorrow morning.
Jennifer, you're gonna lose the account?
Well, we had to get legal involved, but come on, you know John just needs a little hand-holding to talk to the account holders. How about this? You take the kids to the beach while I get on the conference call, then I'll catch up with you shortly after.
Okay, that's fine.
And as for punishment, I can make lunch and bring it over.
Oh, is that so?
Mm-hmm.
All right, but I expect you to come back as soon as you're done with the conference call. Can you bring the peanut butter and jellies? Since they're already made, you should be able to handle that one, right?
I think I should be able to muster up the skill needed for that.
You can't cook in the kitchen, but nobody can top your famous steaks you make on the grill.
I married the best woman in the world, and she loves steak.
I love you. Thank you for working so hard for our family.
Thank you for being patient and flexible with me. Can you take this to the van and I'll take the bag?
Yeah.
Everybody get your six first.
I got five.
Yeah. Woo!
Let's
ready for s'mores.
Let's get s'mores.
Alright. Yeah. Oh, and there. Okay. People like their s'mores burnt, and some people like them.
I've got a great story on bears.
No bears, no bears.
No, no.
Okay, no
not,
bears.
Not that one.
Yay!
This is a story that I was read to us when I was a little girl. Alright, here we go. Once upon a long time ago, there was a man who lived in a giant castle. This man was not just an ordinary man. He was a prince in a big, fruitful country. And in the big castle, there were many servants, and the prince owned many things. Pools, statues, horses, and big boats. But there was one thing he loved most. Do you know what it was?
What?
The prince. The prince loved his sheep the most. More than all of the gold he owned. The prince loved feeding the sheep and bathing them and taking care of them, like any great father would for his children. The prince had over 100 sheep. One rainy day, one of the prince's precious sheep wandered off from the herd and got lost. This devastated the prince so much that he wept. The prince left everything that he owned to find his one lost sheep. He would rather give up everything he had than to forever lost his sheep. So, the prince left his castle and all his possessions to search for the lost sheep. He searched the high mountains, the dry deserts and the thick forests. He searched everywhere. And guess what?
He found his sheep.
The prince found his sheep. He rejoiced and was so happy that he threw the biggest party in all of the kingdom. And he said, "For my sheep was once lost and now it is found." God created everything you see. The stars and the night, the tall mountains and the big oceans. God also created everything we don't see.
Like angels?
Like angels and heaven. Of everything God created, do you know what is most precious to him?
Us.
You. Both of you. And if you get lost, God will do anything and everything he can to find you. Because he loves both of you most. The end. What'd you think?
I like that story.
Me too.
Bedtime
yet? Alright guys, yeah, it's bedtime. We got a big day tomorrow.
Where are we going tomorrow?
The beach, remember? Can we go now?
No, it's too late now. We gotta go to sleep now.
Closed. We'll go first thing in the morning, okay?
It might be closed.
Tonight it is closed, yes.
Like the story.
You're a girl, but we're all kind of like the lost sheep. Sometimes we get lost and we need help.
If I get lost, what God come and look for me?
Of course he would. And I would never stop looking for you either.
Annie,
guess what?
I love you.
I love you.
Good night.
Mm-hmm. If you need anything, Mom and Dad are just going to be in that tent over there, okay?
Okay, thanks. Right. Good night, Mom.
Good night. Good night. We're screwed. Sleep.
Good, good. Except for this freaking rock lodged in my back. Good.
That's not a rock. That's old age.
Oh, come no. Come on. I still have youth in me. Mm-hmm. I feel like I'm 20.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let's see it.
Oh, yeah. You want to see it? Okay.
I do want to see it.
Oh, beautiful out here. Oh. What do you want to see? You want to see it? You want to see it?
Yeah. Yeah, come on.
You want to see it, huh? Yeah? Yeah? Ow! Oh, yep. Nope. Okay. Okay. Yep. That was the rock. Lodged probably in my back. Walk it off, Greg. Okay. Walk it off. Yeah, just a little embarrassed.
Aw. You want a foot massage?
No. Oh, man, I miss those days.
The Marines?
Yeah. You know, I've been thinking. Life is passing by so fast, babe. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember seeing the world in the Corp. Mm-hmm. High energy and exciting. Yeah. And then wanting to settle. And start a family with you. And then I just want to, you know, make it all slow down and spend every moment we have with the kids.
Your life defines who you are. You're a great father and a wonderful husband. The only thing holding you back is that seldom.
Oh. Okay. What happened? Oh, gosh. It's okay. Maddie, come over here. I want to show you something before I let it go.
I want to see it. I want to see it.
All right.
Well, since we're all up, who wants breakfast?
Me!
All right, come on.
That's where we're going to change too, guys. Make sure it's all the way through, though.
Come on, the beach. Hold on.
We are ready to
watch
the world.
Come on.
We're at
2 seconds,
guys.
No, just follow whatever, anything you want, and then what I'll do is back.
Hey, how much longer?
About 30 minutes.
Okay, no rush. I just want to know when we'll be expecting you.
What?
Never mind. Bye.
All right, guys.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fine. Like I said, once I get there, first thing,
I'm place, okay? Can you turn? No, the other way.
Okay.
Thanks. Okay. Really don't want you to fall, so I want to make sure that they stay tight.
You never do fall, though. It's...
Well, I'm going to double knot them just in case, okay?
Okay.
And then you can just take them right off when we get, as soon as we get to the beach. Where's Maddie?
I don't know. I think he just went that way.
Okay, well.
We'll catch up.
Yep.
Maddie!
Maddie!
Maddie, come back!
Maddie!
No.
Maddie!
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 Maddie.
Can you help us? My daughter wandered off. We just can't find her.
Sure.
Okay. Keep looking.
Who are you looking for?
My daughter. Johnny, keep your eye for Maddie. My daughter, Madison, she's like six, and we were walking to the beach, and she wandered off. We can't find her.
Oh. Yeah, it's a big park with lots of interesting things here.
Uh-huh.
I'm sure she's fine. This happens all the time here at the park.
Definitely. I know she's okay. She looks better than to wander off like this. Johnny, do you see something?
No, I don't think.
Wait, Maddie!
Here?
No, you know what? Maybe she went back to the campsite. Can you take us there, please?
Sure. Okay. Of course.
John, come on. Let's go. Okay.
You guys are back early. I was about to head out. What, you couldn't find the beach? Hey. Where's Maddie?
She's not here.
I wouldn't be asking if she was. Seriously, where'd she go? I thought she was with you.
We were on our way to the beach. She walked ahead of us. I thought she'd be here. This park ranger was nice enough to help us out.
I'm sure she's fine. It happens all the time.
Why didn't you call or text me?
I didn't have my cell phone on me. I left it.
If this happens all the time, what's the park's policy or procedure in a situation like this?
Well, we'll go to the station, we'll give your daughter's description, and then the other rangers will go look for her.
All right, perfect. Let's go. Do you want to come with me to the station or do you want to stay here?
No, I'll stay here. I can show my dad.
Can I go with Dad?
That's a good idea.
No, it's fine. Johnny, do you want to come with me to the station?
Yeah.
There might be some cool ranger stuff there.
Cool.
There might be an owl, maybe even a mountain lion, all right?
Will Matt be there too?
Yeah, she'll be there. Go ahead with the guy. Here. Everyone should be all right, right? Just calm down. I will call you if I find you.
both of you. Have you seen a girl wandering off, like, by herself?
No, sorry.
Okay. I'm sure she's fine. I already called the park ranger. She's just lost.
All right, well, if we see her, we'll let the ranger know.
Thank you. Right. Thanks.
Perfect time of year to be here. My parents used to bring me here when I was young. They'd always take me down to the beach. Water was freezing cold, but I love playing in the sand, building castles. Is that where you're headed?
Kind of. Yeah, we were heading to the beach, and then my daughter, she just, like, walked off in front of us.
The beach?
Have you...
There's this great secret spot at the beach hardly anyone knows about. I'd be happy to show you.
Maybe later? Have you seen my daughter?
Well, what does she look like?
She's like yay high, long brown hair, brown eyes. She's six. Like,
I'm sorry. I haven't seen a girl with that description.
Come on. Thanks. Have a good one.
Good luck. I'm sure she'll be all right.
Yeah. I'm sorry, what did you say?
What was she wearing?
She's wearing a navy blue tank and... Oh my god, I see her.
Where are you? Are you still at the camp?
I'm not too far from the campsite.
Okay, listen, babe. The rangers are calling the police. We are coming to you. Stay there, please. Stay there, babe.
Fine.
We have a confirmation. Amber alert has been confirmed. Copy that. Calling all units. We have an Amber alert. Set up a priority one roadblock in the vicinity of Lake County State Park. Suspect, male, 5'10", white. Further details to proceed. Victim, 6-year-old girl, 3'8", 43 pounds. Brown hair, brown eyes. Last seen wearing blue shirt, white overalls. Time of disappearance, approximately 0900. Additional details will proceed. 10-4.
Hey, Rockstar. Want to see something really cool?
Sure.
We got some high-tech stuff in the squad. Come check it out.
So the Amber Alert has officially gone out.
Yeah, we both just received the text alerts. Look, officer, is there anything we can do right now?
We have all of our units setting up road checks. We have men searching throughout the entire area. We have Maddie's picture, and a lot of people are looking for her. The best thing you can do now is contact your family. Have somebody come here and look after your son here.
Okay.
There's going to be a lot of distressed emotions, and he needs a calmer environment.
Okay, yeah, I can call my parents to watch after him.
Okay, good. You want me to call them?
No, I can.
There's a cafe about 5 miles outside of the camp. Okay. I know you haven't eaten for a while. Why don't you go there, grab a bite, have your folks meet you there. My guys are working diligently for you. I have all your information, including your cell phone number. If any updates on Madison, I will contact you personally. You'll be the first to know.
Thank you.
My pleasure, ma'am.
It was right there, and I turn around,
stop,
and she's
stop,
gone.
Stop. Let's not ask the why right now, okay? Let's not do this, okay?
Fine.
We need to stay positive and remain in our faith, okay? Asking
okay.
questions is not going to bring Maddie home any quicker. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you get a hold of your parents?
No, I just sent them a text over. I'm just going to text me back.
Well, you know your dad and technology. That could be a while.
Oh, wait. Oh, I replied.
Oh. Well, what did he say?
He said he'll meet us at the cafe within an hour.
Okay, good. See? Look, I know I said this before, but everything's going to be just fine, okay? Maddie's going to be found.
Okay.
Safe and harmless.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you too.
Just think. Your dad finally figured out how to text, so anything's possible.
I hope so. Johnny!
Come on, buddy.
Baby.
Howdy, folks. How y'all doing today?
Can we please change the channel?
Jen,
I have my phone number, okay? Okay, the detectives have her numbers. They'll get a hold of us as soon as they hear anything. Right? You alright?
Y'all want to order some drinks, some soda, coffee?
Yeah, I'll take a cup black, please. Yeah, anything you want, buddy. And he'll take a Coke and she'll...
I'll just have a hot tea, thanks. Okay, I'll be right back.
As soon as they find Madison, we'll be the first to know, all right? Oh, good. Your parents should be here at the cafe within 30 minutes.
Okay. Tea, Coke. Are y'all gonna be ordering anything to eat today?
Do you want a cheeseburger?
Yes, sir.
And he'll take a cheeseburger, and I'll have the ham and Swiss, and...
I'm kind of just a tea, thanks.
No, Jen, you need to eat something.
I'm hungry.
You need your energy. You know what? She'll have half of a turkey sandwich. You know what? What's your soup of the day?
Let me go check. I'll be right back.
All right.
Everything is going to be okay. Okay? Madison is going to be just fine. The entire police force is out there looking for our little girl right now. But you got to believe everything is going to be okay, and it's going to be over soon enough.
I know. You're right. We just want her back.
Our soup of the day is split pea.
Split pea?
Yeah. It's a green cream base with some ham, peas. It's very good. It's our house special. I highly recommend it.
I'll take one.
Mom, Maddie's hurt. She fell and she's crying.
Okay, where is she?
Outside by the street. She's bleeding really badly.
Okay. Oh, baby, you okay?
Oh, jeez, I'm really hurt.
Okay, I'm gonna pick you up and just put you in the kitchen, okay?
I'll get the door for you.
Thank you. All right, here we go.
I'm gonna go upstairs. Feel better, Maddie.
Okay.
Do you want me to sing you that song? The song that you like?
The sweet pea one?
Okay, come here.
Mom.
What? What's it?
When's Maddie gonna come back?
I don't know, baby. I don't know.
Soon, son. Real soon.
I miss her. Me too.
Me too. And you know what? She'll be back real soon.
Hey.
We got here as soon as we could, hon.
I don't know what happened. I was there. I turned around and she was gone. My little girl's gone.
Listen to me. It's not your fault. You didn't kidnap Maddie.
I know, but it's
okay.
Thank you for coming.
Howdy, cowboy. How's my little partner doing?
Hi, Grandpa.
Hi, Grandpa. I rode my horse all the way here from the west, and all I get's a hi, Grandpa? Why, come on! Your old Coppertooth Gramps needs his two-boot sheriff to pick up his feet and get riding.
Okay.
Come on, you're going to be staying with Grandma and Grandpa.
Okay.
Oh, come on, we're going to have a jolly old time, and before you know it, Maddie's going to be home.
Okay.
Come on, son. Mom and Dad will be joining you and Grandpa and Grandma later, okay? We're going to miss you.
We'll keep him for as long as you need.
And just let us know if you need anything.
Mom, God is with Madison, and I love you.
I love you too, baby.
Bye, Mom.
Are you ready to go back to the park?
Thank you for coming back down.
Yeah. Any leads yet?
Since the Amber Alert event went out, yes, we've received a few leads. A van matching the exact description has been seen several times in this park. We have state troopers patrolling, blocking all of the entrances to the park. We have park rangers patrolling throughout the park. Now, I don't want to alarm you by what I'm about to say, but this is a very large park and it's going to take a while to search it all, like a needle in a haystack.
Okay.
However, I can't stress this enough. We are confident we will find your little girl very soon.
Detective! A van fitting the description has been found. The rangers have surrounded the van.
Has my daughter been found? Is she there?
It's not been confirmed yet, ma'am.
Hey, listen, if that's my daughter out there, we need to be there. How far away is that from here?
About a mile away.
No, this is a dangerous situation. Please stand by and let the police do their work.
Get in the car. You want to drive?
Okay.
See him. Right there.
Yeah.
I think they went that way.
I think, yeah.
What is going on?
Oh! Wait.
Hey,
no,
stop!
Stop!
Do they got him? Do they have her?
I think so.
Maddie!
The van was
not an exact match, nor was the description of the kidnappers.
We've
completed all of our questions in this case. This man is being charged with narcotics, not kidnapping.
What?
This is a false
alarm. Where is our daughter?
Stop. Come here. Stop. Mom, it's okay.
Where is our daughter?
False alarm. She's not here. We're still gonna look for her.
Come on.
I gotta go.
This is ridiculous. Go, get in the car. I'm driving.
Jennifer, I am with you even in this moment. You are not alone. You are not alone. Now get up.
Get up.
And go find her. It's getting late.
No.
We've been at it for hours. We need to get some rest.
Nope.
Jen, you've been through a lot. Okay, we've been through a lot. Okay, you're tired. We're both tired and hungry.
Nope.
Jen, we could have passed Maddie and not even know it. Jenny, you look exhausted, and I'm afraid when you're like this.
Like what?
Like, I don't know, Jen, you're just too emotional, and you're just hurting yourself.
Seriously? You've got to be kidding me.
Jen.
What? You know what? I can't believe you. Like, you're giving up on me.
I'm not giving up.
Then what are you doing? Because it looks like you are.
I'm afraid just as much as you are, but I don't wish for both of my girls to get hurt.
see your little girl. All of this constantly spinning in my mind, and it won't stop.
Sweetie. Hey. Jennifer. This is not your fault.
Craig. I want you to understand that when I close my eyes, I see Maddie. My heart aches not knowing where she is right now. Or wondering how much pain she's in right now. I can't bear the thought. She's in a terrible place with a dangerous man. And she's hurt, Greg. Our sweet girl is in pain and time is ticking. Knows what she's going through. A great evil has been done to the sweet little girl that I gave birth to. Though, I believe that God's with her, giving her hope. I know it's my job to be relentless. So no, Greg, I'm not gonna let my weakness and fatigue stop me. If Maddie's not resting, neither will I. As far as rest goes, screw it. Like, God will be my strength. And he'll be my rock.
Do you remember the night Maddie was born?
Yeah.
While driving through the city to meet with an accountant, I received the call. You were so panicky, I could hear it in your voice. And you begged me to meet you at the hospital as soon as possible. So. And you know, I would never miss the moment of meeting my little girl for the first time. So I got off the next exit on the expressway and turned around. And got to you as fast as I could. And I got there at the right moment to see Madison brighten up the poorly lit hospital room as my eyes gazed into hers for the first time. I was the father of a beautiful, healthy little girl, and I couldn't be more happier. You know something, though? Something that I never told you before?
What? What is it?
Later that night, I found out that there was a terrible 7-car accident, only miles down the highway. I was supposed to be in that accident. My little girl, my baby girl, Maddie, saved my life before she was even born. So, I am ready, and I'm not stopping to save my little girl. I want you to understand that. I'm not giving up, nor will I ever give up. I love you.
I love you too, baby.
Can we just get some coffee or something first?
You're not suggesting I can't be. It's like 45 minutes away.
No, that's fine. Can we just, we'll just find a campsite with an electrical outlet and use the coffee maker we packed? I think that'd be fine.
Yeah, sounds good.
Howdy, folks. We ask that you park at your registered campsite. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't recognize you.
We're just trying to figure out our game plan here. I hope you don't mind. We still want to look for our daughter.
Absolutely. You know, it's just, we've got some flashlights and tools back at the ranger station. I was just headed back that way to get some coffee.
Well, wait, wait. You said coffee?
Yes.
That's something I could really use right now.
I know. Can you just go? I kind of want to stay back and refresh my own way, if you know what I mean.
That's fine. Hey, do you mind if I catch a ride with you?
Absolutely. It wouldn't be a problem at all.
Thank you.
Okay. I love you. Text me when you're on your way back.
I will.
Okay. Why am I even here? What am I doing? Thank you.
quick. I see her. I see Maddie. The car. She's like right, like 50 feet away from me. I don't know why I was driving and I got out of the car and followed this random path. I can't lose her again. What GPS app? Okay, I'm going to my settings. I got it. Are you calling the police? How far are you? Only a few minutes away? Oh, okay. Greg, I can't lose her again. I don't know what to do. What do I do? God, stay the hell away from my family!
Weapon secure. Yep. Weapon secure. Request an EMT, extra EMT, please. Request an extra EMT.
Unit 311, request an EMS.
Okay.
How did it go yesterday?
It's finally over. The verdict's in and he got the complete sentence.
How do you feel about him not seeing outside of a cell for a very long time?
You know, I thought I would feel more of a sign of relief, but I don't. I look at Madison and I wonder what she was going through when she was gone, and I don't know, I just wanted more justice, you know?
Yeah. Well, just because a judge convicts a criminal, that doesn't mean that everyone is cured from the evil that has been done. Yeah. You know, the chapter is done, but the book is still being written. Jennifer, how is your book going to be written? Are you going to have another bitter end, or will there be a sense of hope and forgiveness? Hey, Mads, did you draw that picture that I asked you last week?
Yeah.
What picture? Let's see it.
During our one-on-one sessions last week, she made some comments, and I just asked her to draw a picture for you.
Oh. Come on, let's see it.
Sure. This is me and my mommy praying for the man that took me.
Oh, baby, that's so sweet.
Yeah. You know, we can learn a lot from the little ones, right?
Yeah.
Jennifer, I want you to write a letter to this man, and I want you to be as open and as real as you can. How does that sound? Is that okay?
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay, good.
In my grief, there's a hope that can't be seen. For through the cross, glorified, fits my pain into your design. And though I can't trace your hand, your love is firm like your plan. And joy will come in the morning. This brokenness you will redeem. My Savior is coming. I've walked this road of misunderstanding, so exalt him, Almighty God. Messiah, Redeemer, call the saints into his glory, so exalt him, Almighty God. Though I now for a little while am greatly grieved by various trials, but prove more worth than any gold refined by fire, my faith is found. And though I can't trace your hands, your love is firm like your plan. And joy will come in the morning. This brokenness you will redeem. And my Savior is coming. I've walked this road of misunderstanding, so exalt him, Almighty God. Messiah, Redeemer, will call the saints into his glory, so exalt him, Almighty God. Messiah, redeemer.